Hello everyone, it's me, Scruffy, back again. There is an animal capable of regrowing limbs, even parts of its heart, after losing them. Sounds like science fiction, doesn't it? But it's absolutely true. Today, we will delve into this incredible ability. But before we start, don't forget to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any miraculous stories about the animal kingdom. The animal with the ability to regrow limbs after losing them that I'm talking about is the salamander. This group of amphibians belongs to the order Caudata, notable for their lizard-like appearance but with unique biological features and behaviors. They have long, slender bodies, often with four short legs that allow them to move flexibly both in water and on land. Salamanders have smooth, moist skin, often with bright colors and diverse patterns, not only for camouflage, but also to warn predators about their ability to secrete toxins from their skin. Salamanders live in various environments, from tropical rainforests and grasslands to high mountain regions. They often find shelter under rocks, decaying leaves, or in moist caves to keep their skin hydrated and avoid predators. Some species live entirely underwater, while others can live both on land and in water, exhibiting excellent swimming abilities. The most remarkable feature of salamanders is their ability to regenerate limbs after they have been severed. This is an incredibly miraculous ability that Mother Nature has bestowed upon them, allowing them not only to survive in harsh environments, but also to attract the attention of scientists worldwide. The regeneration process happens as follows. Step 1. Wound healing. When a limb of a salamander is cut off, the regeneration process begins immediately, like a biological miracle unfolding in the blink of an eye. The wound quickly closes with a new layer of cells to prevent infection and blood loss. This is the first and very crucial step in the regeneration process, a step where life and hope are reignited from loss. Step 2. Formation of the blastema. After the wound is sealed, cells from the skin, muscle, and cartilage around the wound begin to move to this area. Picture these tiny, powerful cells migrating like an army preparing for a new, challenging journey. These cells gather and form a group of undifferentiated cells called a blastema, a cluster carrying unlimited potential, like a blank canvas ready for new strokes of life. Step 3. Cell differentiation and development. In this stage, the blastema cells start to differentiate and develop into specialized cell types, like bone, muscle, nerves, and skin. This process is a symphony of complex molecular signals, a melody guiding the cells to know exactly what type they need to become and where to position themselves. The wonder of nature becomes most apparent when each tiny cell finds its place in the complete picture. Step 4. Completion of the new limb. After the cells have fully differentiated and developed, the salamander's new limb begins to take shape. This process includes creating the bone structure, connecting nerves, and forming muscles. The new limb not only resembles the original limb in structure, but also functions fully, including movement and sensation. Miraculously, from a fragment of life, the salamander has restored a part of its body, continuing life with incredible strength and resilience. The regeneration process for a salamander's limb takes about 90 days. During this time, new tissues form and organize, and the regenerated limb begins to restore its function. New muscles and ligaments form and connect precisely with the bones and other structures, allowing the regenerated limb to function normally like the original limb. The final result is a completely new limb, nearly indistinguishable from the original in shape and function. The salamander's regenerative ability has garnered significant interest from scientists, particularly in the field of regenerative medicine. Research on the mechanisms of salamander regeneration can provide crucial insights into how to initiate and regulate tissue regeneration in humans. This could open up hopes for treating severe injuries, limb loss, or even regenerating internal organs. The stark difference between the salamander's regenerative ability and that of many other animals, including humans, clearly shows the superiority and uniqueness of this amphibian in nature. While salamanders can completely regenerate lost body parts, recovery in humans and many other animals mainly relies on scar formation, a simple yet less effective mechanism for restoring function. In humans, when a body part is lost or damaged, the body initiates a wound healing process through three main stages: inflammation, proliferation, and remodeling. The inflammation stage aims to protect the body from infection and remove damaged tissue. The proliferation stage involves the formation of scar tissue, with fibroblast cells moving into the damaged area and producing collagen, a protein that provides structure to the scar tissue. The final stage is remodeling, where the scar tissue continues to mature and restructure. However, scar tissue cannot fully restore the functions of the original tissue. Scar tissue lacks important structures like blood vessels, nerves, and specialized functional cells. Thus, while it protects the injured area, it cannot completely replace the original tissue in terms of function and structure. This is particularly evident in cases of limb loss or severe injury, where scar tissue serves only as a temporary protective barrier. In contrast, the salamander's ability to fully regenerate tissues and organs without leaving scars is due to a much more complex and efficient process. When a salamander's limb is lost, the regeneration process begins immediately with the formation of an epidermal cap to protect the wound and create the necessary environment for the subsequent regeneration stages. Stem cells from the skin, muscle, and cartilage migrate to the injury site and aggregate to form a blastema containing undifferentiated cells. The salamander's regenerative ability surpasses humans in that they not only restore the shape and structure of the lost limb, but also fully regain its function without leaving scars. This makes the study of salamander regeneration mechanisms extremely important and promising in the field of regenerative medicine. Understanding the signals and biological processes that control the salamander's regenerative ability can help develop new treatments for humans, aiming to improve recovery after severe injuries or significant tissue damage. Thus, the salamander's complete regenerative ability is not only a miraculous natural phenomenon, but also opens up significant prospects for medicine, offering hope to millions of people needing treatment for tissue and organ damage. Notably, salamanders can regenerate not only external parts like limbs, tails, and eyes, but also have an incredible ability to restore internal organs, such as heart. Salamanders can fully regenerate their hearts after damage. When a part of the heart is damaged or lost, the salamander's heart muscle cells are not replaced by scar tissue as in humans, but actually regenerate into new heart muscle cells. This process involves the division and differentiation of heart stem cells, creating new heart muscle cells to restore the heart's pumping function. Liver. The salamander's liver can also fully regenerate after damage. When a part of the liver is lost, liver cells begin to divide and grow to replace the lost part, fully restoring the liver's structure and function. This process is supported by a series of molecular signals and growth factors that stimulate cell division and liver tissue recovery. In conclusion, the salamander's ability to regenerate limbs and other body parts is one of the most amazing abilities in the animal kingdom. This ability not only provides biological benefits to the salamander, but also serves as an inspiration and important research subject in regenerative medicine and biology. If you love animal videos, don't forget to subscribe to the channel to discover many more interesting things.